Hey guys, welcome back to another great episode of the Linux channel. In this episode, I'm going to discuss and going to show you how you can build your custom VoIP SIP packet, and you can do it via C Linux raw socket programming. And then I'm going to show you a quick code walk like I have done in my previous episode in terms of building your custom OSPF packet. But here is the catch, you know, the SIP packet is a UDP packet, so you need to calculate the checksums for both UDP header as well as the IP header, unlike the OSPF packet. And you can create almost the same way, and I'm going to show the source code, and I'm going to do a code walk, quick code walk, as well as I'm going to share the source code in my Google Drive or my Traffic Scheduler website, and going to share the link across the YouTube description from which you can download the source. And then I'm going to show you also a quick demo and in terms of compiling this code and generating the custom packet. So in case you are a network admin or a hacker, you can just skip the source code code walk part, and you can just focus on in terms of other aspects in terms of building your custom packet. And here and there you can do some minimal customization, and you can self compile this code, and you can just change it according to your need. So let's just go to my desktop, guys, and let me just show my code, and let me just show you a quick demo of the same. So guys, welcome to my desktop, guys. So what I have done is I have written this piece of code, which is VoIP underscore SIP. I'm just going to open it in my IDE, and I'll do a quick code walk. In case you are an admin, or in case you are a hacker or something like I have discussed earlier, you can just skip this part, and you can just concentrate on the demo part. Anyway, in case if you are looking for any kind of small customization, I hope this code walk is going to help you. I have done earlier an exclusive video on OSPF. Perhaps it has almost the similar source code, but it has few elements which is specific to generation of a typical VoIP SIP packet. So you have this initial part which has all this type tabs and all. So I'm just going to focus on certain elements which is far more important, so that you can understand as well as you can customize. So what I have done is I have done this large buffer which contains the entire UDP header as well as the SIP packet. So the initial 8 bytes are going to be the UDP header. So the checksum part, what I have done is I left them as 0 bytes. So as you can see here, so this is the entire UDP header, and then followed by which you have this entire SIP packet as such. So this is the buffer which is primarily going to be used, and apart from that there is also another buffer which is a layer 2 header, which is the Ethernet header. So it has around 14 bytes, which you can see here, and the type of the Ethernet header is 08 and 00 in hexadecimal, so which is means it is going to be an IP header, followed by which it is going to have UDP header, followed by which it is going to have a SIP packet as such. So what I have done is I have hard coded the source address and destination IP addresses, as you can see here. In case you want to change it according to your NIC card or something, you can just do the modifications accordingly. And apart from that, it is having the code in terms of generating the checksum for the UDP header, and then it is also having a code to generate the checksum for the IP header. I really don't know where I have specifically borrowed this code. It has been almost a decade. I got this code somewhere here and there, lying around. And for these video episodes, I have written multiple small programs, so that each episode I can cover in terms of generating a custom packet via raw sockets in Linux C programming language. So you have this API, so you can see somewhere over here magic TCP UDP checksum. Usually this API is sufficient in terms of both TCP as well as UDP. That's why I think I have renamed as usually as TCP UDP checksum, and inside it calls further this API in underscore checksum. So these two are needed in terms of generating your checksums, and this is needed for your UDP header. And in future episodes, maybe I may use this API for, you know, as well as calculating TCP header checksums as such. And this is needed for both the transport header as well as the IP header as such. So that's all about, you know, these two APIs. And coming down after this, once it is done, the packet is fully generated. I'm storing this packet in this buffer. This buffer is declared over here, and what I'm doing is once it is everything is done, you can see here it has this memcopy and it has this temporary variable, and in this position you can use as a temporary buffer and you can use it in terms of calculating your checksums and stuff like that. So once it is everything is calculated, the UDP checksum, as you can see here, it is written back to this position over here. This is like the sixth byte, starting from zero. So it is written over here, and as well as the same way the IP checksum is written over here. So with this, the entire packet is constructed. So now what we can do is we can prepare the entire final packet, and for that I am copying first the Ethernet header, and then followed by which you can see the offset. After the 14 bytes I am copying this IP header, and after that you can see another offset which is having this Ethernet header size and IP header size, and I am copying this entire UDP and SIP packet as such. So right after that, you can see here I'm initiating raw socket file descriptor, which is sock underscore FT. So this is, as you can see, which I have discussed in earlier video, I should not use numbers this way. These are called as magic numbers. Usually using such magic numbers is a very bad programming practice, and as well as you should not actually define or declare this variables right after some sort of functionality. This may create some sort of confusion in case you are cross compiling it with some other compiler or some other platforms, in case if they are not well suited to handle such a case, or else it may even generate a compilation error as such. Anyway, in this case I'm just compiling this with a simple GCC compiler, and it is just going to work as I can show for you guys as such. So I'm creating the socket file descriptor. The entire socket code is quite complicated, so I have written and pushed in a separate function API as such. So let me just do a quick code walk of the same, and I'm passing the argument as it's a network port. It can be Ethernet 0 or anything as such, the way you wish. So in the create socket, you can ignore this part. This is couple of data structures which is needed for these system calls as such. So as you can see here, first I'm getting the socket file descriptor with the socket system call. I'm using these parameters as sock underscore raw and Ethernet protocol type all. So with this, the socket file descriptor is generated. So right after that, we have to do this bind system call. So for the bind system call, it needs all these parameters, but the most important parameter it needs is interface index. And usually what happens is, once you boot the Linux kernel, the kernel in the kernel space, it is going to assign an interface index for each of these interfaces as such. So we know the interface name, from the name we need to derive its interface index. So what we are doing is, we are using internally IOCTL, and then we are pulling with this command as such. This command, as you can see here, it is get interface index as such. So that's what we are essentially doing. It is a system call and it's an IOCTL, and then it is a get operation, and it is getting the interface index as such. So that way we are getting the interface index, and using that index we are able to successfully execute this bind API as such. So with this, we are done with the socket code, and as you can understand, I can just copy paste this code inside this, but it is unnecessarily going to kind of confuse the context of this main API as such. So right after that, once this sock underscore FT is successfully created, what I'm doing is I'm directly calling this write API, which is again a system call. With this, I'm passing this file descriptor, and then I'm passing this buffer and the entire frame size as such. So in this context, we should no more call it as a packet. This is actually a network frame, and every time you call this as a frame, it should mean that you are adding or else you are including the Ethernet header or data link layer header as well as transport and so on as such. So that's what it means as such. So it is essentially an entire frame as such, so which contains packet and also it contains this data link layer header as such. So that's all guys. So this is my source code, and these bytes, I think this packet I kind of got it somewhere in Wireshark capture, so which you can find it publicly in the Wireshark website. I just taken one sample SIP request from there, and then I have done this code with the packet bytes as such. So let me just compile this code and let's just do a quick demo. GCC minus O VoIP SIP VoIP SIP.c. Yeah, as you can see here, it has got compiled. So before we execute this, we can just VoIP SIP eth 0. So before we execute this, we can open the Wireshark. Since you are capturing the network interface port, it is a security issue, and this is the reason you should open Wireshark with sudo permissions as such. Yeah, so now you can capture the ETH 0 port, and now let's just execute this code. Yeah, as you can see here, it has generated this SIP packet, and you can exactly see there, it has generated according to our Ethernet header, which is this address, which you can cross compile. So exactly these bytes, matches with this generated packet, and then you have this IP packet, IP header, and then followed by which you have this UDP header with the appropriate correct checksums, as you can see here. So this way you can cross check your code, the checksum code or the logic is working fine. So whatever I have done here, and then followed by which you have your entire test UDP packet. So sometimes I use this kind of multiple programs to assess and as well as benchmark my TrafficSquizzer modules, and I kind of optimize and refine, and sometimes I do with the standard test packets, and sometimes I do with live VoIP traffic assets. So this is how you can use a specific raw socket code and generate your custom packets. And in case if you are looking for any modifications, you can directly edit this hexadecimal bytes, or else you can just take another example in Wireshark and then copy paste these bytes and change my source code accordingly. So that's all guys for this episode. I hope you guys liked watching my video. Please do subscribe to this channel guys. So thank you, have a nice day.